I bring you great news. We have a theory, and it's brilliant. It's really cutting edge, it's totally unique, and it's completely pertinent to the world around us in this time and what we know of science. Bear with me. We are not for one moment thinking we could be talking complete nonsense in the following theory. However, after I was met by angels of light, higher beings of blue astral light, humanoid in shape, and they flicked the cigarette out of my mouth, whereupon it set fire to my hoodie in bed, I had to pat out the flames, after I had done something in order that I think contacted the stars, I have meditated on the idea that the higher beings in the universe who look after us and care for us and are there for our betterment, well, how do you have a sentient being made purely from light that you can see, that can travel on a higher plane and show themselves, should they wish to, for merely, it lasted a few seconds, but I'll never forget it. Right, how can you have sentient light? Right, light must wield its own form of properties to handle comprehensive conscious activity. Right, how? I asked myself a million times. Well, let's just take it on, say, first face value of what I saw. I saw humanoid creatures. No, they weren't even creatures. Humanoid avatars, incarnations of sentient, translucent light. Okay, so light, if we take what that was to be real, which I have no reason to believe it wasn't, light can function intelligently under certain conditions that we have no knowledge of yet. Okay, that's the crux. So if light can function intelligently given certain conditions, what if the universe itself is functioning under these light conditions, and we can't see them because we only see a small bandwidth of what's really going on, as you know. That's where we get X-rays, radio waves, microwaves from. That's when we discovered that there was ways of communicating and perceiving reality or hearing reality or sending waves that are beyond our spectral registry. So we know that. That's not even made up. That's science fact. Right, so what if the light works in ways that we have dared not yet believe? Now bear with me on this. Dark matter, what is it? Well, consider computers, if we take the idea that the universe is a simulation. Computers have a place to store memory, don't they? A hard drive. No memory on a computer, they're pretty redundant things really, okay? So what if dark matter is actually long-range intergalactic information storage of our consciousnesses, our collective consciousnesses and experience, where every single moment of observation we witness is being registered somewhere in the dark matter plane on light fields, somehow. I'll leave it there, but it's food for thought, so just imagine the dark matter may be long-range, all-time information storage, subliminally, invisibly, so far, within the intergalactic knowledge of the realm. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Enjoy your think tanks.